Here are some of the qualities of a great husband's great wife. Kardamamuni is great by spiritual qualification. Such a husband is called Tejiyamsam, most powerful. Although a wife may be equal to her husband in advancement in spiritual consciousness, she should not be vainly proud. Sometimes it happens that the wife comes from a very rich family, as did Devahuti, the daughter of the emperor Swayambhu Ammanu. She could have been very proud of her parentage, but that is forbidden. The wife should not be proud of her parental position. She must always be submissive to the husband and must give up all vanity. As soon as the wife becomes proud of her parentage, her pride creates great misunderstanding between husband and wife, and their nuptial life is ruined. Devahuti was very careful about that. Therefore, it is said here that she gave up pride completely. Devahuti was not unfaithful. The most sinful activity for a wife is to accept another husband or another lover. Chanakya Pandita has described four kinds of enemies at home. If the father is in debt, he is considered to be an enemy. If the mother has selected another husband in the presence of her grown-up children, she is considered to be an enemy. If a wife does not live well with her husband but deals very roughly, then she is an enemy. And if a son is a fool, he is also an enemy. In family life, father, mother, wife, children are assets. But if the wife or the mother accepts another husband in the presence of her husband or son, then according to Vedic civilization, she is considered an enemy. A chaste and a faithful woman must not practice adultery. That is a great sinful act. So how Devahuti served her husband Kardamamuni, a great Vaishnava, with what qualities she served him, is being described in these verses. Yesterday we saw, O Vidura, Devahuti served her husband with intimacy and great respect, with control of senses, with love, and with sweet words. Working sanely and diligently, she pleased her very powerful husband, giving up all lust, pride, envy, greed, sinful activities, and vanity. So, very interesting that Devahuti who just got married to Kardamamuni. The central purpose seems to be to serve Kardamamuni, which is actually the central purpose of any marriage institution in the Varnashram. Sense gratification, by default, everyone thinks that getting married is for sense gratification. That may be consequential or incidental, but it is very clear that the main purpose of the husband and wife living together seem to be the husband engaged in devotional service and wife is also engaged in serving the husband who is engaged in devotional service. This could not happen, this cannot happen unless the person is tasting pleasure in serving. When one is more and more his consciousness is towards Sattvaguna, then his standard of pleasure also goes up. When one is more and more entrapped in the animal consciousness, his standard of pleasure goes down. Pleasure has got various levels, finer levels. Ye devahuti, giving up lust, pride, envy, greed, sinful activities, vanity. These are all very natural in the material world of social life. Lust, enjoying one's senses. Pride. The rasa that I have something which others don't have. Envy. The feeling that somebody else has something I do not have. So I have to work for that. All comparison. Pride, envy, all comes out of comparison. Social comparison. If you are locked up alone and you don't interact with the society, then there is no way for pride and envy to manifest. Pride and envy manifest in society, where you live with other living entities. So when you see that somebody else has got something which I don't have, then envy comes. Or you boast that you don't have that, I have this. In your talk, in your behavior, in your everything. That is called pride. When you see that somebody else has got something that you do not have, then envy leads to criticism. Why? Because envy, I don't have, I have to find fault with what that person has got. So you see, behind all these feelings, negative feelings are there behind criticism and all these kind of things. Envy. Then there is greed. Greed means wanting more and more of lust or objects of lust. Greed means wanting more and more possession of sense objects. That is greed. Greed means you want to stabilize the constant supply of sense gratification. Okay, I got now sense gratification. Now how can I ensure that there is a constant supply of sense gratification? That's called greed. Because of greed, you plan. Planning comes because of greed. Lust means you'll just enjoy and leave it, ogaya. Greed means you plan to secure your lust and increase your sense gratification. Then sinful activities, activities which are contrary to the codes of human life, as sinful activities. Sinful activity is happening, or sinful activity, behind sinful activity, you will see there will be lust, pride, envy, greed. So that is why if you see sinful activity, why one should give up sinful activities? Because it's a combination of all these things. Like Prabhupada is talking here about a wife who is not chaste, who looks for another lover, Let's take that as a sinful activity. And see how behind it all these things will be there. Lust. Obviously, lust is there. What is this lust for? Lust does not mean lust. We described yesterday, lust means so many things. Gross and subtle lust. Lust for intimacy. There is mental lust. Lust for secrecy. Lust for being served. Lust for receiving surrender. These are all things which are very natural in this material world, especially as we discussed yesterday. The subtle aspects of conjugal love, conjugal relationship, having all these ingredients of intimacy, secrecy, confidentiality. Kindness, care, love, and then pleasure. Pleasure is last in the list, in a man's lust. In our definition of lust, according to a spiritualist, lust is all kinds of independent enjoyment. You want to have intimacy, other than intimacy with Krishna and his devotees, or Krishna connected intimacy. If you don't have Krishna connected confidentiality, don't have Krishna connected secrecy in interrelationship with people, if you don't desire for Krishna connected care, kindness, love from other living entities, kindness, care, love from other living entities. Women's psychology is inbuilt to give kindness, care, and love. You put them anywhere, they'll give this. And man knows this. So his mind is seeking for this, kindness, care, and love. That is a woman attractive to man. He wants this. And then love, and then pleasure. So lust does not mean only sense pleasure. It means all these things. So all these things you have to dovetail it in Krishna consciousness. It's very scientific. The soul has all these tendencies. It has to be dovetailed in Krishna's service. So, sinful activities behind, it may look like a symbol, okay, no illicit sex. It may look like one item. But as people who know Krishna conscious philosophy, we should understand behind sinful activities, all these fellows are there. Lust is there, pride is there, envy is there, greed is there. Sinful tendency will remain if all these things are still continuing. So lust, pride, envy, greed, sinful activities, and vanity. What is vanity? Vanity means show off. Social show-off is called vanity. You want name, fame, appreciation from the society. One who is free from vanity, I don't care what the world thinks of me. I care for what Prabhupada and Krishna thinks of me. I care for what the Vaishnavas think of me. I don't care what the world thinks of me. So everything, all these things have their own dovetailing in Krishna consciousness. There is self-centered sense gratification. There is self-centered intimacy. There is self-centered love. There is self-centered affection. There is self-centered care. There is self-centered pleasure. In the same way, there is Krishna-centered sense enjoyment. Krishna-centered intimacy, Krishna-centered love, Krishna-centered care, Krishna-centered affection, Krishna-centered love, kindness, all these things. Unlike the Mayavadis, they say all these things are Maya. But we say that these things, when expressed in the material energy, it is Maya. When I come under the influence of devotional service, all these things in devotional service come under the internal energy, it is not Maya. It is the Swarupa of the soul to enjoy intimacy. It is the Swarupa of the soul to enjoy love. It is the Swarupa of the soul to enjoy kindness, giving kindness, taking kindness, giving care, taking care, all this, giving love, taking love, exchanging all these things. It is natural for the Atma to have all these things. So our goal as Vaishnavas is to come to the level of awakening all these things, not suppressing these things. But we want to suppress the wrong expression of these things. We don't want to suppress sense enjoyment. We do not want to suppress love, intimacy, all these things. We do not want to suppress. But we want to find the proper expression of these things. Then the soul is flowering, blooming, it's opening up into its self-realization. Self-realization means understanding the self in all aspects, with all its sensibilities. Self-realization for Mayavadis is Brahman realization, Nirguna Brahman. I don't have feelings, I don't have personality, I don't have identity. I don't have senses, I don't have sensibilities. Nirguna Brahman. Whereas Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, Jivera Nitya Krishna Dasa, Jivera Surupa Hoi Nitya Krishna Dasa. The Surupa of Jiva is not Brahman, but is a Brahman servant. That Surupa of Jiva is Brahman. But what kind of Brahman? A Brahman who has got sensations, not material sensation, but has got the potential to sense things. According to Mayavadis, Brahman cannot see, Brahman cannot touch, Brahman cannot feel all these things. No, it's not. It's all Maya. You have a false ego and Ahankara is doing all these things. But Vaishnava philosophy says Ahankara is able to sense all these things because behind the Ahankara is a real Aham. And that real Aham has got the ability to see, touch, smell, desire, identify all the qualities that we are exhibiting here in this. Originally it is exhibited, it is the faculties of the soul. It is a tendency of the soul. These are qualities of the soul, not qualities that come only when you come into the material energy. Because Mayavadi is a Brahman, falls into material energy, these qualities you take. But we say, no, there are original qualities. These are original qualities. And as Tatastha Shakti, these qualities, either you can express in the material world, or you can express in the spiritual world, in connection with Krishna. So our goal, our aim, is not denial. Our aim, Vaishnava's aim, their goal in life, is to completely open up oneself in its proper expression of love, proper expression of intimacy, proper expression of enjoyment, everything. This is the goal. But we have to go in this direction very carefully according to guidance of the spiritual master. If you don't have the proper guidance of the spiritual master, then that you will not be able to discriminate between this is an expression of my devotional service or it's an expression of my anarthas. We will not be able to differentiate. But at least we should know that. So this is the reason why the devotion service is like a double-edged sword. You have to follow carefully as per the instructions of the spiritual master. You cannot concoct. So we have to tread this marginal path very, very carefully when we are in this material world especially. How do we, what kind of things, what we should do, what we should not do. Just like if you are engaged in sinful activities, then it is very difficult. It is counter to devotional service. Because sinful activities, behind sinful activities, there is a whole bunch of anarthas. Like this we said, lust, pride, greed, envy, all these things are all there. We discussed the other day about intimacy, companionship, friendship. That should be with spiritual master, with Paramatma, the Lord who is seated in our heart. When you're intimate with somebody, what do you do? Or how do you build up intimacy? Simple thing, service, isn't it? So devotional service builds up intimacy with the super souls to start with. In the beginning, devotional service is of both positive free will and negative free will. What is negative free will? What is positive free will? Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, one who sees inaction in action, and action in inaction, is transcendental. Prabhupada says, or the injunction is there, no sinful activities. So when there is temptation for a Vaishnava for sinful activities, he takes the path of inaction. What is that? Negative free will. I won't do. I won't do. That is negative free will. But that only you are saying, only that is only at the soul level it is happening. I won't do. But at the material level, what is happening? Inaction. What is happening at the soul level? Action. I won't do is an action. Generally we think that I won't do means no action. But Krishna is saying, no. At soul level it is action. So it is action in inaction. Now I do something in the material world. Say, I clean the floor of the Lord. I do something. That is positive free will. I do something.
Now that is action. But in that action, how it becomes inaction? Because it is, there is no karma on it. It is as good as no action. So it's, that is a secret. Action in inaction, inaction in action. We have to engage in Krishna's service, in where to engage. Especially for us beginner in devotion service, this is very important, because by doing this, by accepting things favorable for devotion service, rejecting things unfavorable for devotion service, he is pleasing Paramatma, he is pleasing Guru and Krishna. The external spiritual master and Paramatma is satisfying. So he is constantly, what is he doing? The neophyte devotee, to start in Krishna consciousness, he should develop a relationship with the super soul. Relationship means it becomes intimate relationship. Surrender is an intimate relationship. What doesn't please Paramatma, I will use my negative free will. What pleases Paramatma, I will use my positive free will. Suppose two people are living together, constantly some activity is going on between them. Then some relationship is there, no? So if you are doing devotion service, where is your relationship building? Your relationship is building with the Lord in the heart. And it is a genuine relationship. All other relationships are lies or false. Whereas this relationship is true. And the Lord is waiting in the heart of every living entity, seeking the relationship of devotion service. He's seeking. Under the guidance of the spiritual master, under the guidance of the Shastras, there's a guideline how to relate with the super soul, how to relate with the love, how to develop that intimacy. If you don't develop intimacy with the super soul, you feel you will be stuck with. If moment you forget super soul, what happens? Your identity is separated. Some kind of false ego it is. The fact is that we cannot be separated from God. Just like my hand cannot be separated from my body. I can tell my hand is me. But my hand cannot say, I am Madhu Pandit. This is oneness and difference. Similarly, Krishna feels oneness with all jivas. You are all me. Krishna will say, you are also Krishna, you are also Krishna, you are also Krishna. But I am independent Krishna, you are dependent Krishna. We are all gods, but there is one independent God, all others are dependent gods. Mamaivamsa jivaloke jivabhuta sanatana. So this oneness, I am not this dirty body, but I am God. I am not this dirty body, I am God. Obviously body cannot be God. But I am God. But I am dependent God. Dependent God, I am inseparable from the independent God. I am a dependent God. I can never be separated from independent God. This is Jiva's position. This is my position. So I have to behave, I have to act with the dignity that I am God. If you engage in sense gratification, aray, what is it? I am not acting like God. This is not godly activity. I am dependent God. I am supposed to serve independent God. This is my position, constitutional position. then it's a perfect relationship. The independent God is reciprocating with the dependent God. Everything is divine, everything is spirit in the spiritual world. That's why Krishna says, you'll attain my nature. Where does Krishna say, you'll attain my nature if you do whatever I am saying, you'll attain my nature. Because our nature and God's nature is same. We are Amsha, he is Purna. A drop of water in the ocean is also salty, the ocean is also salty. God is divine, I am also divine. We are all divine. So unless we develop this intimacy and respect, Vishrambhena and Gauravena, Vishrambhena and Gauravena, with the super soul, is a very important thing. If this is not developed, then one will fall down for intimate relationship with other human beings. You'll fall. Mundane, material, intimacy, triguna, intimacies. Because you cannot starve the soul. Atma cannot be starved. Potentially, we seek intimacy. It may find so many forces of such things in everybody's life. According to karma, it manifests in so many ways, desire for intimacy. But if one is developing intimacy with the Lord in the heart, which is reality, for a spiritualist, soul is a reality. Soul is a reality, Paramatma is a reality. Body is a temporary reality. But the permanent reality is the soul and the super soul. The moment you understand I am not this body, then immediately one gets connected with super soul easily. Then it's easy to get connected. If you are in bodily concept of life, okay, God is with me, but I don't see God with me. Why? Because God is with me. When you say me, you mean this body. So you search, God is with me. No, he is not with me. But the moment you understand that, no, I am not this body. I am seated in this body. Now Shastra is saying, one more person is seated along with you. You yourself cannot see yourself. How do you expect to see God? Now the Shastra says, you need not see now. You please act. You act as his servant. You re-establish your activity, function. Once you engage in your proper function, one day form will manifest. So therefore we are engaging in devotion service to Paramatma. We go on engaging in devotion service. Name, form, activities of the Lord are all revealed as one engages in devotion service of the Lord. There is a very clear process. If somebody wants fixed up, he has to move out of this, all this vanity, pride, envy. These are all social reactions. One who thinks that I am part of this human society, I am part of this worldly society. We discussed the other day, what is the idea of a worldly society? I think I am this body and I also think you are the body. And I think everybody else is their body. So I have a bodily concept and I project bodily concept on all of you and I create a social concept of life. My bodily concept interacts with your bodily concept. My bodily concept interacts with your bodily concept. From your bodily concept, I want praise. I want appreciation. I want all this. So social needs are created. The foundation is a lie. Neither you are not that body, neither I am this body. isn't it? So foundation is a lie. Foundation is false. So we create society, things that we need from society. When you compare with others, this is a social phenomena. In the material world, when you compare, you are simply engaging in Maya. Pride, envy, you are engaging in Maya. Because that is not, it's all, I am in another world. What is another world of a Vaishnava? Vaishnava's another world is, he also has a society. Because we are a social being. If you cut off from this society, you need an alternative social sense of belonging. As I told you, everything has a original propensity of the soul is there. Aya. You become part of the spiritual community. Which spiritual community? The bottom most is this community, but the bigger communities are there. You are a disciple of A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada. Sense of belonging. And this family. Guru Parampara. See, already you are in a society now. You belong to that society of the Purva Acharyas. You belong to the society of the six Goswamis. Where all they will take you finally to the society of spiritual world will take you. So we identify ourselves with that eternal society. There I want mercy. I want Prabhupada. I am hankering for Prabhupada to bless me. I am hankering for the previous poor acharyas to bless me. One is happy if one receives appreciation from Prabhupada. And you know what all he appreciates, what all he likes. So you seek that. Good. Don't seek in this material world. In the material society, don't seek these things. But you have to seek that pleasure of Guru. Pleasure of Krishna, his teachings. By following his teachings, I want to get the pleasure of Krishna. Get the pleasure of Paramatma, Lord in the heart. Tameva sharanam gacha sarva bhavena bharata. Krishna says, surrender unto him utterly, the Lord who is in your heart. He only is saying. He only is the Lord. But he says, surrender unto him utterly. Tameva sharanam gacha sarva bhavena bharata. But before he had told, sarvasya chaham hridi sannivishta. Ishura sarva bhutanam hridesherti nachisti. He is told. Now he is saying, you surrender unto him utterly. Because Krishna has got Advaitam Achyutam Anadim Anantarupam. So when Krishna, who is before Arjuna, is speaking, he is talking about his Paramatma expansion. And that Krishna himself is telling you, please surrender into Paramatma. He only is Paramatma. Because as Paramatma, I am constantly accompanying you. But in this form as Krishna and Arjuna before, only when you get the good fortune to be in my Leela, you will see me like this. But as Paramatma, I am always there. Come on, surrender unto him utterly. Any time, any moment you can surrender to him because he is available. Accepting favorable for devotion service, rejecting favorable for unfavorable for devotion service. Completely depend upon the Lord. Feel meek and humble. All these things, where do I practice? In my relationship with Paramatma. This is surrender. We practice it. So then, only when there is intimacy, you will surrender, no? Personal surrender happens only when there is intimacy. There is confidence, there is trust, there is love. You get confidence, you get faith in Krishna's words. Sarva dharman pariteja mam ekam sharanam braja. You have faith, you get confidence. Immediately you get. We have to cultivate and culture this relationship. We come to Krishna consciousness, we read Sarva Dharman Parityaja, we come and we surrender. That is a moment of intimacy. Because deep within our heart, some memory triggered of our relationship with Krishna. But we should continue, we should develop, we should nurture, we should cultivate. Therefore, Krishna says, bhakti is something that is cultured and cultivated. Some people think that bhakti means, you know, just like so many things, you have to become famous in this material world. The goal of everybody is to become famous. Isn't it? Famous as a rich man, famous as a successful person. Everybody is working for that. Famous as this. This is a goal of everybody in this material world. Material mind is like that. Maya is like that. In the same way, when they come to bhakti also, they think, I have to become a famous devotee. I have to become like Ramadas of Bhadrachalam. I have to become like that. You don't have no authority to go, you know, even 1,000 feet from a dust from the lotus feet of great devotees. That is your adhikara or qualification. There is a two things, a desire to follow and desire to imitate. You have to be extremely careful. We all have to follow, we all have to desire to follow the great devotees. Imitation means without qualification, you try to do what they did. That is imitation. Suppose there is a great singer and I get a desire, oh, I want to sing like him. And immediately I take the microphone. I'll bray like an ass. No adhikara. This is called desire to imitate. Desire to follow means what? Oh, he became a great singer by so much of practice. What all he did, now let me follow in his footsteps. So you can have ideals. You have to have pure devotees in your mind. You have to have Ramadasu. You have to have all the Prabhupada. You have to have all the every great devotee, Purandaradasa, Kanakadasa, everybody as an ideal. The Goswamis, Sis Goswamis, all the, you know, wonderful devotees whose stories we have heard about. Madhavendra Puri, all these things. Their devotion should impress us so that we can follow. It is not easy. It is not easy for me to learn to sing. To follow is tough. To imitate is easy. So those who want cheap bhakti, they go for imitation. Those who want real bhakti, they follow. So anybody who takes bhakti cheaply, imitation means just imitate the external end activities. That's what I want to imitate that singer. All that person has gone through, I don't see. Only end one, which is very beautiful, very rasa. Rasa is that I try to do it. It will not work. So you hear great devotees, their rasa with Krishna and all these things. Now, you also start talking to Krishna like that. It will not work. You will be braying like ass. Krishna won't even hear you. And you will be in illusion. You have to, bhakti is a science. You have to go through it properly. As per the devotional principles, you have to follow. That is the reason why guidance is required always. Be on a track. Just like we don't go, everything about bhakti, what we are doing is, we are going on a track given by Prabhupada. The moment something new, we are always afraid. We want to check whether this track is correct or not. Whether this track, somewhere some imitation is there or not. I want to track. When I follow the instructions, automatically instruction means following, not imitating. Jai Granthraj Srimad Bhagavatam ki jai, Jagat Guru Srila Prabhupada ki jai.